Today on Monson Made This, it is all about the sauce.
Ryan Little.
The dish I'm going to be making today, which is a mushroom and tofu lettuce wrap, is inspired by a couple experiences I've had at Thai restaurants where I've had this very herbaceous, very bright, acidic, spicy sauce. So I chased a few recipes online, combined a few things, and created this dish so that I could highlight this sauce. So let's go ahead and make this sauce and then I'll show you what we're going to put it on. To start making the sauce, I'm going to need one very important ingredient, and that is my homemade vegan fish sauce. The recipe for this is linked down below in the full recipe. It just takes a little bit to make, so I wanted to make it ahead of time. It's basically just shiitake mushrooms and some Bragg's liquid aminos simmered down. Fish sauce doesn't really give it a fishy flavor. It gives it just kind of an umami boost, and that's exactly what this does. So I'm gonna use a third of a cup of this. All right, to that I'm going to be adding 2 teaspoons of sugar. You could probably use a liquid sweetener if you wanted, like agave syrup, or maybe even maple syrup, but this is a vegan granulated sugar. To that I'm going to be adding 1 tablespoon of sambal. This is just a chili paste. If you don't like heat, you can use less of this. But it does add a lot of really nice flavor. For some more heat, I'm going to be adding some dried chili, and I'm just gonna be breaking that up in here. I need the juice of 1 lime. And the last ingredient I'm going to add after this is going to be the garlic. The reason I wanted to assemble these liquid ingredients first is so that the sugar can dissolve before I add all of the herbs into it. So here's my garlic. I have 2 small cloves. You want probably the equivalent of 1 large clove of garlic. Just get that in there. All right, and then I'm going to stir it up, again, making sure that sugar at the bottom gets dissolved. You need 3 different herbs for this dish. You need cilantro, mint, and green onion. And you need 1/4 cup of diced cilantro, 1/4 cup of diced green onion, and then just about 1 tablespoon of the mint. So this is the sauce. It's full of herbs. Like I said, it's gonna be spicy and really acidic. To let the flavors marry together a little bit, set this aside for maybe 15 to 20 minutes before you serve it, but try not to make it more than 2 hours before you're actually gonna serve it, because the flavors can get a little bit muddy. So let's set this aside and make the rest. As I said, this dish was all about the sauce. And I was trying to think of something that would really be great to put this sauce on, to keep with kind of the experiences I've had before at Thai restaurants, which is normally with sort of like a beef dish. So I came up with these mushroom tofu lettuce cups. You could use the same base that I'm about to make here and put it over rice as well, but it's just a really great accompaniment, a nice saltiness to go with the really bright herbaceousness of the sauce. So I'm gonna start with the kind of marinade that will go on this afterwards, and I'll chop up the rest of my mushrooms and tofu. For this sauce, I called it a marinade, but basically it's just the sauce that I'll put on it when the mushrooms are pretty much done cooking. We're gonna start with 2 tablespoons of our vegan fish sauce, and then 2 more tablespoons, if I can open it, of Bragg's liquid amino. You could also use soy sauce. I just happen to really like the flavor of Bragg's. All right, so there's 2 tablespoons of that. And then I have 2 cloves of garlic I'm going to crush in here. Stir that around and just let it set aside until we're ready to add it to the pan. I developed this recipe using a 10-ounce bag of already sliced cremini mushrooms, and I'm just gonna slice these a bit more to get them smaller. So you can use any kind of mushroom that you want. You just wanna make sure to chop it up into smaller pieces. I'm not making them too fine of a dice because mushrooms do cook down quite a bit. They'll reduce by about half. So I'm keeping them in slightly reasonably sized chunks, but still chopping them down from this original slice. I have my pan on high heat here and I'm adding some olive oil. You could make this recipe oil free if you wanted, but I do think that the oil really helps the mushrooms to brown. I'm gonna be adding all of the mushrooms into this pan. And this is about a 12-inch skillet, nonstick. You wanna make sure it's a pretty good size so that you don't have the mushrooms too much stacked on top of each other, but they will be obviously crowding the pan a bit. So I'm gonna just kind of let this sit for a minute and brown up and reduce. You want these mushrooms to go down by about half. And you can toss them every couple of minutes or so, but don't move them around too much because we really want them to brown on all sides. Also, if you have a friend or somebody that you're cooking for that doesn't like mushrooms, you could try different things. You could try vegan chicken. You could try just all tofu. But I think mushrooms are really great in this, a really nice meaty flavor and texture. So let's slice up the tofu while this cooks. I have one block of teriyaki baked tofu here. You could probably sub any other tofu that you want. This is about 3 ounces worth here. And I'm just cutting this up into really small cubes. I'm gonna be putting this in after the mushrooms are pretty much finished because this doesn't need to cook at all. I just wanna brown it up a bit at the end. Also, if you notice with the mushrooms, I didn't add any salt to them. That also will help them brown. All the seasoning will come at the end when I add the soy sauce, vegan fish sauce, and garlic mixture. All right, so there's our tofu, and I'm just gonna set this aside while I wait for my mushrooms to brown up. While my mushrooms are browning up and cooking behind me, I'm gonna take this time to prepare some more vegetables that are gonna go in this dish. I have some cucumber and peanuts that are gonna be garnished for the final lettuce cups, and then this carrot, which I'm actually gonna be adding to the tofu and mushroom mixture right before I'm done cooking it. So let's julienne this carrot. If you don't have a julienne peeler, you can just do a fine dice on this or try your best to do your own julienne peeling. I'm not cutting. I'm not the best at it. I do like this little handy tool to help me. And you want most of a carrot. I would say it's probably gonna be about maybe like a quarter to a half cup. I'm gonna keep them in long strands. Just gonna cut them in half and that'll set aside until I'm ready. Next thing, the cucumber. Just gonna slice this in half. This is an English cucumber. It is technically seedless, but it does have a little bit of a very liquidy seed portion down the center. So I'm gonna scoop that out before I slice it. And then I'm just gonna thinly slice these on a bit of an angle. These have been browning up in this pan untouched for maybe about 4 or 5 minutes. You can see they got a beautiful golden color on the bottom. Also, there's not much liquid released at all because I didn't salt them as I had said. And I'm just gonna let these go, toss them a bit. Let them hang out for another little while so they can brown up on their other sides. Just want to chop up a bit of some roasted and salted peanuts. This is going to go on the top at the end. This is just to add a bit more saltiness and crunch. Obviously, if you don't like nuts or peanuts or can't have peanuts, you can omit these. I've turned the heat down to medium. They're pretty much browned on all sizes. They've reduced down quite a bit. You remember how much I put in there originally. And to that, I'm going to add up my chopped tofu. You just want to toss that around a bit. And again, leave this alone, let things brown up. Tofu is brown, the mushrooms are brown. I'm going to be adding some of that fresh julienne carrot to this. Stir that around a bit. I don't want these to get too cooked. I still want them to have a bit of freshness to them. and the sauce. I'm gonna turn it down to pretty much low and add the garlic, vegan fish sauce, and Bragg's liquid aminos. And the last thing you wanna do here is just kinda stir it up, let it cook down, let all the liquid evaporate, let the carrots wilt down just a little bit, and then we're ready to serve. Gone ahead and plated this all up. Here we have our finished product, beautiful mushroom and tofu lettuce wraps with a waterfall-inspired sauce, fresh cucumber, and crispy, salty peanuts. I'm hungry, let's assemble one of these and give it a taste. So I'm gonna put pretty generous helping of my tofu and mushrooms. Top it off with a few cucumbers. Nice, generous drizzle of that very herbaceous waterfall sauce. And then a few peanuts for crunch and saltiness. If you didn't want to do lettuce cups, why don't you just put this on a bowl of rice? Just as delicious. Sorry if I'm a mess, but this thing is so good. The iceberg lettuce just gives a perfect crunch. The saltiness, the sour, the herbs, the sweetness from the carrots, and the sugar that we add to the sauce, it all comes through. This is so good. Hits the spot. Started out with this sauce idea. Started out with the idea of recreating this amazing sauce, and it's just perfect. So give this a try. If you like it, thumbs up, subscribe to my channel, and I'm gonna finish this, but I'll see you next week for another video.